Hey guys, today I wanna help you out to complete the Capstone Dungeon, brother. The level 50 Capstone Dungeon, the Cathedral of Light, brother. This works for softcore and hardcore, but this character that I have right here, which I am going to show you everything, is a hardcore character. This is a hardcore druid. Of course, everything here is related to the druid. This is the class that I know. So, be here and you will learn how to beat the Cathedral of Light and not die on the attempt, brother, especially if you are playing hardcore. In terms of the skill tree, by the way, I am using the same build that I already told you guys. I have a video explaining this whole build, so I will leave the link down in the description for the build, and I will leave you the video open here. This is the tree, but you got a better explanations if you go watch that video. Basically, we are using a Storm Strike and Pulverize, and we are getting a lot of Fortify and Unstoppable, and we take advantage of the pets, of course, and we have survivability with Fortify, and we hit harder hard with overpower attacks that take advantage of that Fortify, brother. That is basically what we are doing in here, my dude. In terms of items, I am also using the same items that I told you in that video that I was going to use, with a couple of changes. This is what happens. I told you in that video that I was going to give you only legendary aspects that are on the Codex of Power, so you can reliably get the build. But if you get something good on a drop, you can use it. For example, I got in a drop the Chokewave aspect, and this makes Pulverize, creates a Chokewave that travels forward, dealing 90% of its damage to targets in the path. This is a really good legendary for this build. Of course, I didn't say to you, you need this, because what if you don't get it? I only gave you stuff in the Codex of Power. But if you get this, use it, my brother, use it. I got it, then I am using it. The other thing that I got, and I didn't know at that moment that this was going to be the craze, is this unique ring called Mother's Embrace. Because when I uploaded that video, that was before the game release, and when you complete the campaign and you kill the final boss, not giving you a spoiler in here, and you kill the final boss, they give you this ring, this unique ring. So I am using it. Those are the only two changes. Everything else is exactly the same as in that video, brother. I am using ballistic aspect for fortify and ranks, the quicks and to slow enemies, and I am using air the skill, deal more damage to crowd control enemies. I have tons of crowd control. I extend the duration of earth and bulwark with this, with mending a stone. I have this one is really good, brother. While unstoppable, and for 4 seconds after, you gain 10% increased movement speed and can move freely to enemies. When you have your earth and bulwark on, you move through enemies, brother, because this keeps you unstoppable. This is awesome, and you run really fast. This will help you survive if you are playing hardcore, brother. And then we have retaliation, that your core skill steal 40% increased damage based on your amount of fortify. I have tons of fortify. The other change with regarding that build is that I told you guys to use blue gems in your armor, because that gave you damage reduction while fortified. But now that I am playing the game, I am noticed it is not while you have fortify, it is while you are fortified. And these are two different states. Having fortify is when you see here on your life that you have extra life overlapping. You know, it is like a darker red or a brighter red. But when you are fortified is when you get a ring outside of your life, and that means that your amount of fortify is higher than your real life. Now that I am playing, I am noticing that I am not fortified as much as I want. I have tons of fortify, but I am not fortified a lot of the time. So I wouldn't take as much advantage of the blue gems that give me damage reduction while fortified. So I just use the red gems that give me extra life, and that's it, brother. And on the weapon, I use the red ones. This is the same, because this gives me overpower damage. So those are the changes in terms of gear. Now, things to take into consideration while playing the game, and now I am going to switch it up to the dungeon so you can see it. First of all, consumables, brother. Use your consumables. I use in the dungeon, I don't have it anymore, but in the dungeon I use for the Cathedral of Light, Manslayer Elixir, because the Manslayer Elixir gives you extra damage to every human mob, and in the Cathedral of Light you will find mostly human mobs, so it will give you that stuff. Plus, if you are playing hardcore, and I am playing hardcore, I always have my Scroll of Escape on, and I have it a keybind, where you just press the keybind and you get out of there ASAP. If you are playing softcore, you don't care about that shit. If you're playing hardcore, I use also an elixir of cheat death. It is called elixir of death evasion. That means if you take lethal damage, you get invulnerable for 2 seconds and you don't die. After 2 seconds, you can die again, of course. This elixir doesn't overlap with other elixirs, so you can have the elixir of Manslayer and at the same time have the death evasion elixir, brother. It is awesome. I did that, of course. By the way, I took every single possible advantage that I could when I got into the Capstone Dungeon. As you can see, I am level 49. I did the dungeon at level 49. Some people have made it sooner, some people made it after. The dungeon is supposedly made it, so you do it at level 50 plus. I did it at level 49. And I'm gonna be honest, it is harder than I thought. I thought it was going to be a breeze in the park. I thought it was going to be a joke. And it isn't a joke. It is the hardest thing I have ever done. No, but it is harder than I thought. It is, if you are not careful, you can die. So if you are playing hardcore, be aware of that, brother. Be careful with what you do. Now, I also got gear upgraded to tier 3. As you can see here in the dots, I have 3 dots and another dot in here. I didn't take it to the 4 dot. Why? Because the first 3 dots are cheap and easy to get, but the 4 upgrade asks you for the materials that you get by salvaging legendary items. So I didn't want to spend those materials on upgrading these items because I may be going to need them to craft new items, you know, to craft new legendaries, because you need them to imprint aspects into them. Again, I tried to get every fucking advantage that I could, so I got the 3 upgrades on them. I also did my Altars of Lilith and my Renown, brother. As you can see here, I got Renown until the 3rd tier for every fucking faction. Well, not for KG Stan, but for every single faction, I got it until tier 3 because they give me an extra potion. I have all the 9 potions that you can get in the game. Check this out, 9 potions. You can get more than 9. That is the max. Of course, I have them upgraded to my level 45, the last upgrade. I also have all the Altars of Lilith that I could get. Check this out. I have them maxed out because they give you stats. I took every possible advantage that I could at my level, brother. And it paid off. I went in, I cleared the dungeon. It is cool. Again, it is harder than I thought it was going to be. Now, inside the dungeon, there are 2 things that I want to tell you that you have to be aware of. Be careful about the big dudes that have pointy heads. They have the armor that Vigo had at the start of the game in Act 1 in the campaign. Be careful with those guys. They CC you, so be prepared with your unstoppable, and they hit really hard. Whenever you can, try to kill them first because they are dangerous as fuck. Of course, don't overcompromise trying to kill them and put you in a bad spot, but try to kill them first. And in the first boss, there are 2 bosses in the Cathedral of Light, and the first boss is a 4 boss fight. One of them is one of those big dudes. Brother, kill the big dude first, or try to kill the big dude first. He's the most dangerous one. And in every pack of mobs where there is a dude like that, try to avoid him to not get hit by his big swing, because he will CC you and hit for half your life or more. And try to kill them first, brother. And that is my guide for the druid, brother. Use the pulverized veil, because everything in here is in the Codex of Power. You can use the unique that is dropped for the last boss on the campaign. And if you get the choke way aspect, use it. It is really good. These are the abilities that I use. This is my skill tree. I will leave the link down in the description so you can check it out and just have it on hand to be able to skill everything. I got my Renown. I got my Altars of Lilith. I got my potions. I got my elixirs. And I completed the dungeon, brother. And be careful about those dudes with the pointy hat, brother. And yes, guys, I hope this is helpful to you. Thanks a lot for being in here. You guys are fucking awesome. Tell me in the comments below if you already did the Capstone Dungeon, if you are starting out the game today and you are going to do the Capstone Dungeon. How is it going for you? Is this helpful? It is not helpful. I love reading comments, brother. Thanks for being here. You are fucking awesome. Remember to like and subscribe to the video. God bless you. And remember, as the great Bill Hicks said, this is just a ride.